Welcome to SST College of Arts and Commerce. This is SST Udupedia. Myself, Maithili Gaurishankar, Assistant Professor of Maths, going to teach you SEM 1, FIBCBI, BMS and CS, common topic, diagrammatic representation of the data. What is diagrammatic representation of the data? The purpose of data presentation is summarize data and the data of collected data in a diagrammatic representation, the accurate view of raw data. Statistical data represented in the table, sometimes it is not interesting and becomes difficulty for a layman to understand. A visual representation is much better and attractive way than the numerical table data. Diagrammatic representation gives visual representation and understanding of the data is very easy in the diagrammatic representation. So it is help to compare more than one data and conclude the result very easily and in very less time. There are two types of diagrams. One is one dimensional diagram and another one is two dimensional diagram. In one dimensional diagram, we are going to see bar diagram. This is the simplest type diagram. It is generally useful for converting the data from qualitative and quantitative to a diagrammatic representation. The bar diagram is a data where the rectangle bars on the xy axis we used to draw with the given data. So the given data is taken in x axis and in y axis we are taking the values of the frequency. So we will get the bar diagram. The height of the bars are taken proportional to the value of the variable. So this is one example we are having. The simple bar diagram, here the data given for that are years and profit in millions. 1995, 1996, 1997, 1998, 1999. So that one we are drawing in the x-axis, the plot is taking in the x-axis for years. For y-axis, the frequency, the profit in millions was taken, that is 15, 20, 25, 32, 45. So plotting this according to the height in y-axis, we are getting the bar diagrams. What is the difference between histogram and bar diagram? In histogram, continuous bars will be there. But in bar diagram, we are having gaps between the bars. Second problem, this is also for simple bar diagram. The number of factories for 4 years is given below. Draw a bar diagram. So year was given in the grouped data, 1994 to 95 1995 to 96 1996 to 97 and 1997 to 98. The number of factories are given in 105 93.3 96.7 96.9. When we are drawing this, we are getting the bar diagram with the values in xy axis, taking years in x axis and number of factories in y axis. Drawing for the height 1994 to 95 105 1995 to 96 93.3 1996 to 97 96.7 finally 1997 to 98 96.9. The result of the table is given in the PPT. Next one, multiple bar diagram. We are having, if more than two details are there, we want to compare more than two values, means we are using this multiple bar diagram. Similarly, like simple bar diagram, x-axis is taken below all the x values and frequency is taken on the y-axis. So the heights are taken is proportional to the value of the component or variables. Here we are going to see two types of bar diagrams. First, we can see the example for multiple bar diagrams. Here it was given imports and exports of the year 94-95, 95-96, 96-97 and 97-98. So here we comparing the values of import and export and drawing in multiple bar diagram. We are taking the year in x-axis and value of imports for 94-95 as given 17,170. For export 11,850. We are drawing the import was represented in the dark shades, but exports are represented without shades. So like this we want to represent, similarly like simple bar diagram, we are drawing the multiple bar diagram with two datas. It was given in the screen. Next, subdivided bar diagram. This is also multiple bar, one of the type of multiple bar diagram, where in one single bar we are going to make it segment and represent the difference, and we can also compare more than one datas here. So to show different components, different shades are using here. We can see one example. So following data give oil seed crop production estimated for kharif season for the year 97-98. Oil seed are given as groundnut, soybean, sesame. For the state Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, it was given in lakhs in ton. So we want to take in subdivided bar diagram the total values of data. So here for Rajasthan the data, total data is 4, Uttar Pradesh 3.15. So we want to first draw the height of the bar for this total measurement. After that we can divide the one bar with the detail of groundnut, soybean and sesame. Below it is groundnut, we are marking for 2.00, soybean 1.25. Sesame 0.75. So the representation of the segment are given in different shades. For groundnut, no shading is there. Soybean, slight side lines are there. For sesame, full black shade is there. Similarly, for Uttar Pradesh, we are drawing the bar diagram with the height 3.15 and separating 0.20, 1.25, 1.70. So the diagram was given in the screen. Next, two dimensional diagram is percentage bar diagram. In one dimensional diagram, only the length of the bar are taken into account and width is only for visual impression. In two dimensional diagram, both the dimension and the area of the diagram is taken into consideration. So here percentage bar diagram we are going to see. So this is the example. The following data is collected in a survey of some students from some schools. Draw the percentage bar diagram. First we want to convert the given detail into percentage. Here it was given first school, second school, third school, fourth school, and science, commerce, their number of students taken admission in that class. So school first we are having total number of this 90 and 60 is 150. Number of students in commerce 60, and we are calculating here the data of number of students for percentage of students for commerce team. So 60 upon total 150 into 100, that is 40%. Similarly, second one we are calculating. So 20 is the common students, 80 is the total number of students of second school. So 20 upon 80 into 100 is the answer, that is 25%. Third one, 25 is the commerce group, 50 is the total number of students, then 25 by 50 into 100 equal to 50%. Fourth one, 24 is the commerce people and 40 is the total number of students, 24 by 40 into 100 equal to 60%. These are the percentage given for commerce. How to find for science stream? Subtracting 100 minus 40, 60 is science. 100 minus 25, 75 is science. 100 minus 50, 50 is science. And 100 minus 60 is 40 is science. So using this detail, one of the detail is enough to find the second in the bar diagram. We are taking school first, second, third, fourth in x-axis. Stream of inclination, that is taking in the y-axis. So in the first we are taking 60% of science with the shade blue, we are notating the representation, and with the magenta color we are representing the comma stream. So what is the difference between subdivided bar diagram and percentage bar diagram? In subdivided bar diagram we want to draw the bar with the total height, but in percentage bar diagram we are taking 100, that is percentage of the percentage bar diagram. So we have the maximum value is 100. In there we are separating, we are drawing the partition. So the diagram was given in the screen. Next to pie diagram. Sometimes the number of component of a variable is large. An alternative method to represent the number of data other than multiple subdivided percentage bar diagram is pie diagram. Pie diagram gives more clear visual impact and it is easy comprehensible when the values of the component of the variable varies in a big range. A pie diagram is a circle divided into different sectors where the sector represent different component of the variable. So in pie diagram we are drawing a circle. So we are going to use the formula of area of circle pi r square. The area of the sector is proportional to the value of the component. The area of the circle represent the total value. That is, since the total angle of the circle is 360, we are calculating using that. If one of the component given is 200, means we are converting it into the degree value, like 200 upon total component value into 360. Using that formula, here we are getting 48 degree. As 200 is one of the component, total component is 1500 into 360, giving answer 48 degree. So one of the example we are going to see, the following table gives the area irrigated according to source for 1987-88. Sources given are government canals, tanks, wells and tubes, tube wells, others. Area given in measurement, angle given in degrees. So we want to calculate this 2 degree. The area given as 15.7, 3.8, 19.5, 2.9. Total is 41.9. So 15.7 upon 41.9 into 360, we will get 135 degree. 3.8 upon 41.9 into 360 gives 32. Similarly, we are calculating this. So the radius approximately taking as 3 units. The area of the circle we are taking calculating 22 by 7 pi r square using the formula. We are getting 28.29. This area represents the total 41.9. Therefore, the scale we can take it as 1.48 for 1 square unit. Using these ideas, we are drawing the table and representing the sector with different shades. Government canals, tanks, wells and tube wells, others are represented in different shades. The diagram was given in the screen. Following tables gives area under high yielding varieties. Here two values are given, 2 years comparison was there. So for this type also we can draw the pie diagrams. Pie diagram circle. So 1980-81 they have given wheat, rice, jowars, bajra, maize. And also 1990-91 also same detail given. Angles in degree we want to calculate with the same procedure. 6.48 upon total number of this is 15.38 into 100, sorry, into 360. We will get the answer 151. 5.59 upon 15.38 into 360, we are getting 131 degree. 0.80 upon 15.38 into 360, we will get 19 degree. 2.05 upon 15.38 into 360 gives 48. 0.46 upon 15.38 into 360 gives 11 degree. Total degree is 360. Similarly, we can calculate for 90, 90, 91. So here we are comparing two datas. So we are comparing the radius also in the diagram, and according to the given radius we are doing the calculation. So one of the total value is 15.38 taking the root, and another one is 43.07 taking the root. We are getting 3.92:6.56. So one circle is with radius 3, other circle is double the circle of first circle, that is 3 into 2, that is equal to 6. So we are taking the radius of first circle is 3, radius of second circle is 6, and we are separating the segments using for the given details like wheat, rice, jawar, bajra, maize. Using the protractor we are plotting these values which we are having in angles and degree. So this is the two pie diagrams you can see in the screen. Thank you, students.